Hello, friend. How are we doing today?
Hi, Yuki, good girl. Good girl, yeah. Hey, Kinsey. Hey, Kinsey. Oh, that's my little rodent. Hi, Ginger. Wait a minute. You're not Ginger. Get out of here. Hi, Ginger. Yeah, hi, Ginger. Good girl.
Welcome back, Shell Squad, as we discuss how to differentiate male versus female red ear slider. Let's get it. By the end of this video, you'll be sexing turtles like a pro. I mean determining gender, you know what I mean. For most of you out there, you're not gonna have a turtle this size. You're probably gonna end up buying a turtle that's a hatchling size, which is roughly the size of a quarter. And what's very fascinating and amazing about turtles, red ear sliders in particular, is you can actually ask the breeder what the sex is or the gender is, and they can tell you. This is because red ear sliders obey the law of temperature sex determination, TSD, TSD. What that means is if the so what that means is the higher the temperature they incubate the eggs at, they should turn out female. And the lower the temperature, they should turn out male. Now, there's a little in-between area where they will turn out a mixture of male and female. But typically, breeders will breed for either males or females. So ask your breeder, he will know. So if you don't know the breeder when you're buying the turtles, then you're gonna have to wait until your turtle is roughly about 4 inches long. You can actually see gender as early as 6 months if they're growing fast. But typically, it's gonna take about 2 to 4 years. Males tend to reach adult size in a couple years. This dude probably won't grow much longer than this. So if you weren't able to ask the breeder if it's a male or a female, then all you need to do is make sure your turtle is roughly 4 inches. This one's a little past. And let's check this other one here just for comparison. So we are looking at two turtles similar in size. Now one of them is a male and one is a female. It might be hard to tell and right away. The key feature being they need to be 4 inches minimum. You can do it earlier, like three and a half, to start looking for clues, but you can't be guaranteed unless they're about 4 inches. So the first indicator is the shell size. So you can see here, this one is big, and her shell size is like 7 inches already. So if you're seeing that, well, anything over 6 inches is almost guaranteed going to be a male. Typically, males will run about 4.5 to 5.5 inches. This one here is roughly 5 inches, which is on the larger end of the sizes. And if you can see here, that's actually a female. So we'll get into that a little bit more, but this is a female and she's almost 6 inches, so that would make sense because males rarely get this size. Now here's a male that's the same age as the female, and as you can see, he's 4.5 inches. He might get to 5.5, but typically they run about 5 inches at full size. Here you go. That's the male. Are you noticing any differences yet? So the next best way, sorry, I'm gonna have to do this to you, is for educational purposes, I'm sorry, is tail size. Look at this dude's tail and look at hers. His tail touches his foot, wraps all the way around, and her tail is really small. In fact, if you put them next side by side, you'll see that his tail is even bigger than hers. And look at the size difference. That is just remarkable, huh? So that's a pretty, oh, I'm sorry. Let me get you back over. So that is one of the key ways to tell if it's a male or female, is that tail right there. It should look like that. If I can get that tail out, I will get you guys a good shot. But just for comparison, here's a female's tail at about the same size. She's smaller, but you can see that the tail is definitely smaller as well. We like to describe these male tails as long and thick, and the female tails as short and skinny. So that's kind of what you're looking for. Which takes me to another clue. In fact, one of the biggest clues. Look at this guy's claws. Redder slider males will have this very long claws, and they use that to woo females to breed with them. Sorry, it's windy out here. They also use it to hold on to the females when they're trying to mount the female, kind of like that. Okay, it looks something like that. The male will wrap his long tail around the female's short tail, and then they'll be kind of stuck together like that. Okay, now the female's claw, now remember, she's bigger. Look how short that is. Oh, she's got a little damage right there on her claw. I wonder how that happened. Not to worry, she's in good health, but check that out, the claw size difference. I'm gonna do side by side for comparison. Just look at that claw difference. It's a pretty big difference, easy to spot, especially when the males have his claws flared out. Now let's take a look at this big female. Look at her claws, they're all even too, see? All right, so these two side by side, even this little male on top, his nail is still longer than the female on the bottom. It's pretty crazy. I mean, look at the size difference. It's just a, you know, big difference here. And the last thing we're gonna look at is head shape. As you can see, these two are similar in age, but her head looks bigger, and that is typical. The heads look much beefier in the females, where the males' heads are a little longer and thinner. I'm gonna show you guys a side profile, and you guys can see the difference. Oh, there we go. All right, so check that out. The male has much more of a pointed nose than the female, right? And the male's got slightly thinner head, especially near the ear area. I mean, that's like hard to tell. I think the easiest signs to become a pro is making sure they're 4 inches, looking for the long claw, and looking for that long tail, okay? Check her out. So what I want to tell you here is the males flutter their claws, but so do the females. The females will do it to females, the males will do it to males, the males will do it to females, and the females can do it to the males. It could be a sign of aggression, it could just be playful, or it could be a sign of trying to breed. Congratulations, you are now a pro. So thanks for watching. If you have any recommendations, please post them in the comment section below. Please consider subscribing as we try to hit 1,000 subscribers this year. Shell Squad Leader out.